The Darrieus wind turbine has been tested for some time, and it's time to start generating electricity. Search online for generators. This one seems to come up quite often. Click to see. In addition to being a generator, it also has a built-in driver and can be used as a motor. Maybe it's the motor for the air conditioner. The package arrived. The main shaft is a little tight. Although the Darrieus wind turbine is highly efficient, it is not easy to start on its own. This motor can just be used to start the wind turbine, and when the speed is sufficient, it can be used as a generator, killing two birds with one stone. Five lines in total. Check the seller's instructions. The red line VM is the power supply to the motor. Note that it is DC, which can reach 310 volts. The black wire GND is the ground wire. And the negative terminals of all power supplies are connected here. The white line VCC is the working power supply, which is used for the control board inside. The instructions say to connect DC 14 to 16 volts, but I only connected 12 volts. The yellow line VSP is the speed command. 0 to 6 volts corresponds to motor speed. The higher the voltage, the faster the speed. Finally, there is a blue line PG, which is speed feedback. The specific signal is not explained. Simply test the power generation, connect the LED bulb, turn it lightly and it will light up. Both forward and reverse rotation can generate electricity. And regardless of direction, positive electricity is output from VM. Therefore, rectification is not necessary when generating electricity. Then make a circuit board to control the motor operation. The circuit diagram is shown on the screen. The circuit is completed. Start testing. VCC is powered on. AC 110 volts power on. Switch to the left for motor mode. Adjusting the variable resistor can adjust the motor speed. Switch to the right for generator mode. The load bulb lights up. Switch centered for neutral mode. Motor isolation neither generates electricity nor rotates. In addition, the speed feedback signal PG cannot be measured directly. Add a pull-up resistor and measure again to get a square wave signal. Add two voltage and ammeters. Then install it on the wind turbine. Start testing. The wind speed is about 2.2 meters per second, and the wind turbine cannot start by itself. Switch is in motor mode. Turn the variable resistor to start the motor. To drive the wind turbine rotate. The wind turbine continues to accelerate. After a while, when the speed exceeds 120 RPM, stop motor, switch to neutral mode. The wind turbine can be maintained at around 120 RPM. The meter occasionally shows a small current, which may be VCC interference. Unplug it, then disappear. Switch to power generation mode, the LED bulb lights up. There is indeed electricity generated, but the current is so small that even an ammeter cannot measure it. Change to a 50 milliampere ammeter and try again. Start the wind turbine again, this time increasing the wind speed to 2.5 meters per second. The wind turbine continues to accelerate. After a while, when it reaches 60 RPM, stop the motor. Will the wind turbine accelerate on its own? Negative. The wind turbine slows down, indicating that the starting speed is not enough. Continue to accelerate with the motor. After a while, when it reaches 120 RPM, switch to neutral mode. Stop the motor. Unplug the VCC terminal to clear abnormal readings. The wind turbine continues to accelerate over 135 RPM. Switch to start generating electricity, and the current instantly exceeds 40 mA. Due to the load torque during power generation, the speed of the wind turbine will decrease and the current will also decrease. After a while, the final current was about 20 mA and the speed stabilized around 114 RPM and no longer decreased, indicates that power generation can continue. Now weaken two of the fans to reduce the wind speed. The speed of the wind turbine begins to decrease. After a while, it almost stopped. It means that the wind turbine cannot drive the generator under the current wind speed. The wind speed has dropped. Can we still generate electricity? Of course, there is a way. Start the wind turbine again. Accelerates to 120 RPM. Stop the motor. Speed increased to 127 RPM. Start generating electricity. The speed begins to decrease after a period of time. When it reaches 110 RPM, just cut off the load. The speed will rise again. As the speed approaches 120 RPM, start generating electricity again. The speed also dropped as a result to 110 RPM and then cut off the load. The speed rises again. Repeat the cycle. Therefore, as long as the speed is kept not too low, power generation can still be generated intermittently. But the intermittent process feels very disappointing. At such low wind speeds, is there any way to generate electricity continuously? There is still a way. Buy a MOSFET made into a PWM module. Connect it between the generator and the load. Start testing. This time the wind speed was only about 2.2 meters per second. Start the wind turbine to 120 RPM. Switch to generator mode. The LED bulb does not light up because PWM has not started yet. PWM is set to 50% duty. The bulb is on. The oscilloscope displays the PWM signal. The current speed is about 115 RPM, continues to decrease. Assume that the expected speed is no less than 100 RPM. Can it be done? After a while, the speed continues to decrease below 100 RPM. Set PWM to 20% duty, the speed increased and returned to above 100 RPM. A while. Increase PWM to 25% to maintain speed. Therefore, by adjusting the load through PWM, continuous power generation can be achieved even in weak wind conditions. And it can also be used to maintain the wind turbine at the optimal speed to achieve maximum efficiency. In small Darrieus wind turbine applications, starting by a motor is a good method, especially in this era when motor control technology is efficient and cheap. When enlarged, the Magnus rotor can be used to start the wind turbine. In this way, only small motors are needed, eliminating the need for high power drivers, making it cheaper and energy saving.